After visiting some famous squares last week, we promised to visit some famous triangles this week, and here they are. The Old Town Triangle, the Bermuda Triangle, Pascal's Triangle, Sierpinski's Triangle, and whatever triangles these are. Well, we've also found another triangle, the cities of Springfield, Illinois, St. Louis, Missouri, and Hannibal, Missouri, form an equilateral triangle that, with a little rounding, shows that each side is 100 miles long. And we've made up a problem where we've gone from Springfield to St. Louis at 50 miles an hour, St. Louis to Hannibal at 40 miles per hour, and Hannibal to Springfield at 60 miles an hour, and we're trying to find the average speed. So we'll examine the first leg, Springfield to St. Louis, and it takes 50 miles to go an hour, then 100 miles after 2 hours, and that one's easy, 2 total hours from Springfield to St. Louis. So now we look at St. Louis to Hannibal at 40 miles per hour. 40 miles after an hour, 80 miles after 2 hours, we have 20 miles to go. So if it's 40 in 1 hour, it has to be 20 in a half hour, so another half hour gives us a total time of 2.5 hours from St. Louis to Hannibal. And our final leg is from Hannibal to Springfield at 60 miles an hour. Well, of course, 60 miles an hour is the same as a mile per minute. So if you go 100 miles, you need to go 100 minutes. And then 100 minutes is equal to 1 hour and 40 minutes, or 1 2/3 hours. So now we'll summarize. Each leg is 100 miles, and the times are shown. We'll add up the distance to get a total of 300 miles. The times are a little harder to add up. We go for a common denominator, 6, and we get 5 7/6 hours, more commonly written as 6 1/6 hour. Then we visit one of our favorite formulas, rate times time equals distance. We know the time, we know the distance. We substitute them in as shown here, so we're missing the rate, and we'll use the inverse operation. 300 divided by 6 1/6 will give us the average rate. And then we go to our trusty calculator, which doesn't do mixed numbers very well, but there's a workaround, and it's shown here. This is the way you would type 300 divided by 6 1/6 into a calculator of this sort, and we get this answer. Our job is to round it off to the nearest mile per hour, which rounds off to 49 miles per hour, the answer to this week's problem of the week.